Pernicious anemia is a type of megaloblastic anemia caused due to the lack of a substance called intrinsic factor, which leads to deficiency of vitamin B12. Now, intrinsic factor is a glycoprotein produced by parietal cells in the fundic region of the stomach that helps vitamin B12 to be absorbed by the body. Vitamin B12, along with folate, is necessary for the synthesis of a protein called thymidine. Now, thymidine forms one of the building blocks of DNA, and deficiency of thymidine causes abnormalities in rapidly dividing cells of the body, especially red blood cells. Impaired DNA formation in the erythrocyte precursors leads to premature apoptosis of these cells in the marrow, causing a dip in the number of red blood cells, leading to anemia. Vitamin B12, known as cobalamin, is present in eggs and animal foods and is not found in vegetable and fruits. So B12 is attached to binding proteins in food and is released from these proteins during peptic digestion in the stomach. The fundic region of the stomach housing the parietal cells secrete pepsin, which helps in releasing vitamin B12 from its binding proteins. Once detached, vitamin B12 attaches to a salivary protein called R-binder or haptocourin. Now, this vitamin B12 haptocourin complex passes through the stomach to be separated by pancreatic proteases in the duodenum. So, once released, vitamin B12 attaches to a glycoprotein called intrinsic factor that is secreted by the parietal cells in the fundic region of the stomach. So, this vitamin B12 intrinsic factor complex, once in the distal ileum, attaches to intrinsic factor receptors present on the intestinal enterocytes. And once it attaches to the receptors, the complex is endocytosed by the ileal enterocytes, and vitamin B12 now associates itself to another carrier protein called transcobalamin 2. And after being secreted out of the cell into the plasma, transcobalamin 2 carries vitamin B12 to other parts of the body. This process clearly shows why intrinsic factor is important for vitamin B12 absorption. Hence, a lack of intrinsic factor causes malabsorption of vitamin B12, leading to deficiency states causing pernicious anemia. Now, an autoimmune attack by T cells on the parietal cells of the gastric mucosa leads to gastric injury and a lack of production of intrinsic factor. Why or how the autoimmune attack happens is not known. The gastric mucosal injury further triggers formation of autoantibodies against the gastric mucosal cells. In fact, there are three types of autoantibodies reported. Type 1 antibodies that prevent binding of vitamin B12 with intrinsic factor. Type 2 antibodies that prevent binding of vitamin B12 intrinsic factor complex with the receptors on the ileal cells. And type 3 antibodies that target the parietal cells. However, it has to be understood that these antibodies, though diagnostic for pernicious anemia, are not primarily the cause of the condition. It is the autoimmune attack by T cells that causes the condition and triggers the formation of autoantibodies as well. So pernicious anemia usually occurs in persons greater than 30 years of age and could affect adults of either gender. It presents with general symptoms of anemia like pallor, weakness, fatigue, shortness of breath, and headache. These symptoms reflect the blood's reduced oxygen carrying capacity. Pernicious anemia also presents with neurological symptoms like tingling and burning sensation in the extremities, paresthesia, and numbness. This is due to the fact that vitamin B12 also functions to maintain myelin in the nervous system. This condition has also been reported to present with gastrointestinal symptoms like nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. As for the oral symptoms, glossitis is the main symptom of pernicious anemia. The papillae are atrophied, either throughout the entire surface of the tongue or in patches. Generally, the inflamed erythematous tongue in pernicious anemia is described as beefy red and is called as Hunter's glossitis or Moeller's glossitis. The inflammation in the tongue has periods of remission and exacerbation, and this might alter the taste sensation and may also cause a burning sensation of the mouth. Pernicious anemia is diagnosed by decreased levels of vitamin B12 in the serum with normal levels of folate. Serum antibodies to intrinsic factor are specific for pernicious anemia. A blood smear may reveal a macrocytic and a hypochromic picture. In vitamin B12 deficiency, erythrocytes are large, hence macrocytic, and have more than usual amounts of hemoglobin and stain darker, hence hyperchromic. However, it has to be noted that the increase in hemoglobin in each individual erythrocyte is only proportional to its size, and the overall concentration of hemoglobin is actually reduced due to the decreased number of erythrocytes. Another characteristic finding is the presence of hypersegmented granulocytes. Bone marrow aspirates may reveal megaloblasts, and gastric analysis shows achlorhydria, or the absence of hydrochloric acid in gastric secretions. As far as the treatment is concerned, intramuscular injections of vitamin B12 have shown to improve the symptoms, both systemic and oral symptoms, rapidly. High doses of oral cobalamin therapy is an equally effective treatment.